afternoon and welcome to Holy Trinity Episcopal Church in Juneau, Alaska for our noonday prayers. O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord,
make haste to help us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Psalm for today is Psalm 73, the entire thing. Let us read this responsibly by full verse. Truly, God is good to Israel, to those who are pure in heart. But as for me, my feet have nearly slipped. I have almost tripped and fallen. Because I envied the proud and saw the prosperity of the wicked,
for they will suffer no pain, and their bodies are sleek and sound.
In the misfortunes of others, they have no share. They are not afflicted as others are.
Therefore, they wear their pride like a necklace, and wrap their arms around them like a cloak.
Their iniquity comes from gross minds, and their hearts overflow with wicked thoughts.
They scoff and speak maliciously. Out of their haughtiness, they plan oppression.
They set their mouths against the heavens, and their evil speech runs through the world.
And so the peoples turn to them and find them for fault.
They say, how should God know? Is there knowledge in the Most High?
So then these are the wicked, always at ease, they increase their wealth.
In vain I have kept my heart clean, and I have washed my hands in innocence.
I have been afflicted all day long, and punished every morning.
Had I gone on speaking this way, I should have betrayed the generation of your children.
When I tried to understand these things, it was too hard for me,
until I entered the sanctuary of God and discerned the end of the wicked.
Surely you set them in slippery places. You cast them down in ruin.
Oh, how suddenly do they come to destruction, come to an end and perish from terror.
Like a dream when one awakes, O Lord, when you arise, you make their image vanish.
When my mind became embittered, I was sorely wounded in my heart.
I was stupid and had no understanding. I was like a brute beast in your presence.
Yet I am always with you. You hold me by my right hand.
You will guide me by your counsel, and afterwards receive me with glory.
Whom have I in heaven but you? And having you, I desire nothing upon earth.
Though my flesh and my heart should waste away, God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever.
Truly, those who forsake you will perish. You destroy all who are unfaithful.
But it is good for me to hear God. I have made the Lord God my refuge.
I will speak of all your works in the gates of the city of Zion.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Hebrews. Consider him who endured such hostility against himself from sinners, so that you may not grow weary or lose heart. In your struggle against sin, you have not yet resisted to the point of shedding your blood, and you have forgotten to the extortion of the addressees as your children. My child, do not regard lightly the discipline of the Lord, or lose heart when you are punished by him. For the Lord disciplines those whom he loves, and chastises every child whom he accepts. Endure trials for the sake of discipline. God is treating you as children. For what child is there whom a parent does not discipline? If you do not have the discipline in which all children share, then you are illegitimate and not his children. Moreover, we have human parents to discipline us, and we respected them. Should we not have even more willing to be subject to the Father of spirits and live? For they disciplined us for the short time as it seemed best to them, but he disciplines us for our good, in order that we may share his holiness. Now disciples always seem painful rather than pleasant at the time, but later it yields to the peaceful fruit of righteousness to those who have been trained by it. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Lord, hear our prayer, and let our cry come to you. Let us pray. O God of grace and mercy, give your blessing to the Diocese of Alaska. Watch over our churches, sustain our people, strengthen our leaders. Through the Holy Spirit, guide and guard the diocese, keeping it always under your care and protection. Let us be a loving family, serving you in faithful devotion to the gospel of your Son, Jesus Christ. Give your blessing to Mark, our bishop. Give him a spirit of courage and right judgment, a spirit of knowledge and love. Let your Holy Spirit be his companion. Let your gospel be always in his thoughts. May your presence in his life be a light for all to see in every good work for the building up of your people and the glory of your holy name. Give us the blessing of your example. Help us to follow in the way of Jesus today and every day. Give us compassion at the center of all that we do. Compassion for ourselves as disciples still young in faith. Compassion for others as members of our own family and God. Let us become examples for others as so many others have been examples to us, through your love and for the sake of your glory. Watch over all elders and the brothers and sisters of the Society of St. Simeon and St. Anna. If any are in a time of sorrow, sickness, or need, give them the touch of your healing hand. If any are in times of joy, thanksgiving, or fulfillment, give them the song of angels to praise your name. Let us be your servants in this life, just as we will be your sons and daughters in the life to come. I invite your personal intercessions and prayers at this time.
Lord, watch over those who are without shelter this day. Keep them safe. Hide them beneath the shadow of your wings.
Today the church remembers Cornelius the centurion. O God, who by your Spirit called Cornelius the centurion to be the first Christian among the Gentiles, grant to your church such a ready will to go where you send and do what you command, that all prejudices that bind us might cease, and that we might welcome all who turn to you in love. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. May God's love be the love that surrounds us today. May God's peace be the peace that we share on our way. May God's grace be the grace that our actions display. May God's truth be the truth in the words that we say. Amen.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May Christ our Savior give us peace.
And grant you a happy birthday, Wilson. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.